In this section, we are going to discussing about the bacterial diseases, major bacterial diseases present in finfishes. There are mainly three types of bacterial diseases present in finfishes. The first one is surface ulcerative type, and second one is acute systematic type, and third one is chronic granulomatous. Chronic granulomatous type. These are the three major types of disease present in finfishes. And the surface ulcerative type, it is characterized by the hemorrhagic surface ulcer. Hemorrhagic surface ulcer in finfishes. It is the characterization of surface ulcerative type bacterial disease. And acute systematic type, it is the presence and proliferation of bacteria in internal organs. That is characterized, the acute systematic type characterized by the presence and proliferation of bacteria in the internal organ. And the third one, chronic granulomatous. It is characterized by the formation of granules or nodules due to the colonization of bacteria. These are the three major types of bacterial disease present in finfishes. And there are different types of disease. We already discussed in an earlier video the different types of disease, gram-negative and gram-positive bacteria causing disease in fishes, such as aeromonasis, then pseudomonasis, vibriosis, advanceliosis, then enteric red mouth disease, and the bacterial kidney disease, rhinobacteriosis, then mycobacteriosis. These are the diseases caused by bacteria. Then common symptoms of bacterial disease. This also we are discussed in the previous video. The common bacterial disease of finfishes are lethargic swimming, erratic swimming, loss of appetite, that is anorexia, then respiratory distress, then exophthalmia, bulging of eyes, the fishes jumping out from the water, then necrosis, tissue death, then color change of the gill and mucus production, then hemorrhage, then fins become frayed, and the lesion damage of the body surface or fins. These are the common symptoms of bacterial disease. And now we are discussing about the disease, common disease present in aquaculture or finfishes. One of the major disease, bacterial disease in aquaculture or finfish, it is columnaris disease. The causative agent of columnaris disease is Flavobacterium columnarae. It is mainly affected in freshwater fishes such as tilapia, then carp, channel catfish, goldfish, then rohu, ayu fish, etc. And the symptoms of this particular disease is necrosis of gill tissue, the death of the gill tissue or damage of the gill tissue, and hemorrhagic ulcer. Hemorrhage occurs in the gills and it is leads to ulceration. Then white spot in the head and fin surrounded by a red tinge is the one of the major clinical sign of columnaris disease. And the treatment methods, there are common treatment methods of bacterial disease and any other disease in aquaculture. It is maintained good water quality. Here it is also maintain good water quality, and we are used some antimicrobial agents, and we are used some antibiotics for prevent and control the disease. Here we are used copper sulfate and the antibiotic oxytetracycline applied through the feed for control and prevent the columnaris disease. Then another bacterial disease is known as advarcilliosis. It is caused by Advarcella tarda. It is mainly affected in tilapia, channel catfish, mullet and carps. Then the major symptoms of this particular disease: abdominal distension, abdominal problems, or abdominal dropsy is occurring, or the clinical sign of this advarcilliosis. Then deep cutaneous lesion also occurring in the abdominal area. These are the major symptoms of the advarcilliosis rather than the common symptoms. The treatment methods of advarcilliosis is given the oxytetracycline, that is antibiotic, and improve water quality, then maintain water quality. Another disease is vibriosis. One of the common bacterial disease present in feed fish is vibriosis. It is caused by Vibrio angularum and Vibrio vulnificus, and it is mainly affected in the grouper, rabbit fish, then millfish, sea bass, etc. That is mainly affected in the marine and estuarine fishes. And the symptoms are darkening of the body due to necrosis and abdominal dropsy, the fluid accumulation in the abdominal cavity, also cause mortality in fishes. Then treatments: give oxytetracycline in the cultured fishes, and also we are used nitrofurosone. Antiseptic agent is used for treating this particular disease. Then another disease is Aeromonasis. Aeromonasis is caused by Aeromonas hydrophila, Aeromonas septicemia, Aeromonas cavia. These are the species of bacteria causing aeromonasis in fin fishes. And it is mainly affected in tilapia, millfish, then catfish, snakehead, and etc. And major symptoms are scale protrusion or loosening of the scale due to the dropsy, and hemorrhage. It leads to ulceration and mortality will occur. These are the major symptoms of aeromonasis. And how to avoid this particular disease? Avoid by the means of overcrowding. Avoid overcrowding of the fish in the pond, or avoid overcrowding the fish in the cultured system. That is one of the prophylaxis measure we are taken for aeromonasis. And also we are used antibiotics like tetracycline, oxytetracycline, etc. Then another disease, it is red spot disease. Red spot disease caused by Pseudomonas fluorensis. Pseudomonas fluorensis is the bacteria causing red spot disease in fin fishes, and it is mainly affected in the millfish, goldfish, tilapia. Okay, these are the fishes mainly affected due to red spot disease. And major symptoms of this particular disease is body reddening. So it is called as red spot disease, reddening of the body, or red spots are appearing in the body surface of the fishes. And swollen belly. Belly will be swelled because of fluid accumulation and gas formation. And skin lesion, the damage of the skin. These are the major symptoms of red spot disease. And we are used oxytetracycline and nitrofurosone. Oxytetracycline and nitrofurosone are the antibacterial and antiseptic agent we are used to control this particular disease, and also maintain the proper stock and maintain the water quality to avoid this particular disease. Then next disease is streptococcal infection. Streptococcal infection, it is caused by Streptococcus bacteria. Streptococcus bacteria causing streptococcal infection in fin fishes. It is mainly affected in sea bass, tilapia and rabbit fish, ayu, etc. Then major symptoms, it is anorexia, then erratic movement or irregular movement of the fish. These are the major symptoms seen in streptococcal infection. And how to avoid or how to prevent this disease? We have to avoid overcrowding. Avoid overcrowding and maintain good water quality to prevent the particular disease. And we are using erythromycin for treating the streptococcal infection. Then another disease, it is mycobacteriosis. Mycobacteriosis is caused by Mycobacterium marinum. Mycobacterium marinum is the species that causes mycobacteriosis in fin fishes and is mainly affected in Siamese fighting fish. One of the ornamental fish in our society is Siamese fighting fish. And major symptoms, skin discoloration and external lesion in the fin as well as in the body part. These are the major clinical signs of mycobacteriosis. Then treatment, bath treatment with potassium permanganate and apply chloramine B or T. That are the antiseptic agent. We are using chloramine B and T for treating this mycobacteriosis. Then another bacterial disease is eye disease. That is mainly due to the proliferation of Aeromonas liquefaciens bacteria. Aeromonas liquefaciens bacteria causing eye disease in Cutlacutla and other carp species. And the major symptom of this particular disease is the eyeball get putrefied and it leads to death of the fish. And the treatment methods, it is bath treat with potassium permanganate and oxytetracycline, the antibiotic added through the feed. Then these are the treatment methods and we have to prevent this disease by maintain good water quality. And another one of the major disease, it is dropsy. Aeromonas hydrophila, the bacteria causing dropsy. It is mainly affected in Cutlacutla, Mrigal, IMC and other freshwater fishes. The major symptoms of dropsy are accumulation of water or accumulation of body fluids in the body cavity. And this causing the scale protrusion and loosening of the scale. The treatment methods, they are bath treatment with potassium permanganate. It is the major treatment method we are used for dropsy. And also we are using antibiotics and antiseptic agents. The next disease, it is ulcer disease. Ulcer disease caused by Aeromonas and Pseudomonas species. And it is affected in Indian major carps, then exotic carps and catfishes. Then symptoms, major symptoms of the ulcerative disease. It is epidermal cells as well as scales are lost. Then hemorrhage and it leads to ulceration and lesion. Also the clinical signs of ulcer disease. Then major treatment methods. Treat with potassium permanganate and sulfadiazine, then terramycin. These are the major treatment methods we are used to prevent the ulcer disease. Thank you.